Hello students, welcome to my channel. Let us solve another problem from GATE 2005, question number 82. A tractor is equipped with a hydrostatic drive which includes a variable displacement pump and fixed displacement motor. The input to the drive includes torque of 250 Nm and speed of 2500 revolution per minute. The pump displacement can vary from 42 cm³ revolution to 0 to 42 cm³ revolution in opposite direction, while the motor has a fixed displacement of 42 cm³ per revolution. The volumetric efficiency of pump and motor are 96% and torque efficiencies are each 90%. The maximum permissible pressure drop across the motor is 35 MPa. The maximum output power of motor will be less, the transmission efficiency of drive will be less. So let us, this is about the hydraulic transmission system. So let us go to the solution. So first of all, in the hydraulic system, transmission system, there will be a pump and there will be a motor. So pump is driven by the tractor engine or shaft power. Here let it, this is the shaft power and this is pump, this is motor. So this is a variable displacement pump, so variable displacement pump, and this is fixed displacement pump. But in this case, it is asked to find out the maximum power developed or output power from the motor in this case. So maximum power, or it means the two powers are there in this case. One is the shaft power, let it a shaft power pump and shaft power motor. So this is the output power, this is the input power, and there will be two powers will be there, that is power output from the pump and power output from the motor. Power output from the motor is SPM and power input power, input power to the pump will be SPP, that is the shaft power. And there will be one discharge from the pump, that is QPO, that is the discharge from pump output, and same will be equal to discharge motor input. And there will be discharge, same will be equal to discharge to the output of the pump motor, that is QMO, since there will be no loss in between. And there is a pressure drop of del P M motor, it is given. So now coming to this, first of the QPO you have to calculate, or motor pump discharge, output pump discharge, QPO. So we know that volumetric efficiency is given, that is VM and pump are same, that is 0.96, and torque efficiency, that is motor and torque efficiency of pump, both are same as 0.9, it is given. So volumetric efficiency and torque efficiency are given. Now we know the, also it is given the torque of the shaft power to the pump is given, that is 250 Nm, and the speed of the pump or shaft, that is equal to 2500 RPM, it is given revolution per minute. So now from this we can calculate the power required to the motor and pump. So first of all, the this is fixed variable displacement pump, so the revolution 42 cm³ per revolution to 0 to 42 cm³ per revolution, and this one is fixed 42 cm³ per revolution, the displacement. So now here actually the speed is not given in the motor, so but in the pump the speed is given, the motor speed will be different. Now first of all, you would find out QPO. To find out that one, we know QPO will be equal to volumetric efficiency of pump into input QPI, QP pump discharge, that is input discharge to pump, this one. So input discharge to pump QPI will be how much, that is NP into DP by 60, that is centimeter cube per second. So since dp is the displacement, in this case it is given this 42 centimeter cube per revolution. Since it is asked to find out the maximum power, so let us see the maximum discharge or is 42 centimeter cube per revolution. Maximum is this one. So therefore, 42 putting this one, NNP is 2500 rpm, putting this QPI and NVP is 0.96. The QPO will be directly calculated as 0.96 into NP is that is 2500 into DP is 42 centimeter cube per revolution divided by 60. So that will be equal to 1680 centimeter cube per second. So this is the pump output discharge QPO. Now this QPO will be equal to the Q input to the motor. Q input to the motor is QMI. So QMI will be equal to QPO. So now we will find out the QMO, that is the motor output. Motor output will be equal to again NVM into QPO or QMI, that will be equal to 0.96 into 1680, that will be equal to 1612.8 centimeter cube per second. So this is the pump out motor output. Now also the torque efficiency is given. So you know the torque efficiency of motor is given, that is equal to the power output at the motor divided by the pump input to the motor, that is the power. So that is how much power, that is the discharge output from the motor into the pressure drop. Maximum pressure drop in the motor is given, that is del Pm. So therefore it will be equal to SPM is we have to calculate, and NTM is given. So therefore this 0.9 will be equal to SPM divided by QMO is 1612.8 into 35 megapascal, that is 35 megapascal 10 to the power 6 newton per meter square. So therefore SPM will be equal to the maximum motor output will be equal to 1612.8, that is centimeter cube per second, and to make it meters cube per second, you can multiply 10 to the power 6, that is meter cube minus 6 meter cube per centimeter cube into 10 to the power minus 6 newton per meter square, and to make it watt kilowatt, there is 1000 has to be divided, then motor output will be equal to 50.8 kilowatt. So this is the maximum motor output from the motor output power, that is 50.8 kilowatt. Now coming to the second part, that is overall efficiency or transmission efficiency is given. For that you have to find out the input power. The input power is SPP, shaft power to the pump will be equal to 2 pi n t by 60. So n p and t p, that will be equal to 2 pi into n p is 2500 into 250 t divided by 60,000, that will be equal to 65.45 kilowatt. Now the transmission efficiency, will be equal to the in output power, it is the motor power, that is 50.8 kilowatt divided by input power is 65.45 kilowatt into 100, that will be equal to 77.62%. So therefore the transmission efficiency, that is output power from the motor divided by input power to the pump, that is 77.62. Therefore two answers, one is 50.8 kilowatt and that and the second one is 77.62. I hope you get the answer. Please like and subscribe to my channel.